Of squares, we are going to talk about another interesting concept of Pythagorean triplets. Now, the name might be a little known to you, Pythagoras theorem. We have learned about that, right? Okay, so let's not talk about that. First, let's see what is Pythagorean triplets. So yes, this has a very close relationship with Pythagoras theorem, therefore it is named this way. Triplet means it is a set of three numbers. So Pythagorean triplet is a collection of three numbers such that the sum of the squares of the two numbers is equal to the square of the third number. Let's take an example. Let us suppose that you have three numbers, 3, 4 and 5. So if these three numbers are such that square of 3 and square of 4, if you do their sum, you get square of 5. If this relationship holds true, then 3, 4, 5 is a Pythagorean triplet. So any three number such that sum of the squares of two numbers is equal to the square of the third number. So if this relationship holds true, that means those three numbers form a Pythagorean triplet. And what are each number called? Each number is called a member of the Pythagorean triplet. For example, here 3 is a member of the Pythagorean triplet, 4 is a member of the Pythagorean triplet, 5 is a member of this Pythagorean triplet. So 3, 4, 5 forms a Pythagorean triplet. Now let me tell you how is it related to the Pythagoras theorem. So let's quickly recap the Pythagoras theorem. So the Pythagoras theorem holds true only for right angled triangle. So if you have a right angled triangle, say ABC, where AB is the perpendicular, BC is the base on which the perpendicular is drawn, and AC is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is that side which is exactly opposite to the right angle. Then as per the Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars and the base. So do you find any resemblance between the Pythagoras theorem and this triplet concept? Yes, because they are talking about almost the same thing. So when we say 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square, it is almost like your hypotenuse is 5, your perpendicular and base are respectively 3 and 4 respectively. So that's the link between Pythagoras theorem and Pythagorean triplets. In fact, this is why we call, so any three numbers which satisfy the relationship of the Pythagoras theorem, those three numbers are called Pythagorean triplets. So let us take another example. So let's say you have three numbers, 5, 12 and 13. So do you think that they form Pythagorean triplet? So let's check. Now whenever you want to check if it satisfies the relationship of Pythagoras theorem, what are you going to do? Just look at the three numbers. Whichever is the biggest number, that is going to be your hypotenuse. So let's, in this case, 13 is the biggest number. So in this case, what you will do, you find the sum of the squares of the other two numbers, that is 5 and 12. So find out 5 square, add it up to the square of 12 square. So you get 5 5s are 25 and 12 square is 144. So this is equal to 169. Now you find out the square of the biggest number, that is 13 square. So when you find it out, you see this is also 169. Therefore, you see that 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. So that means the relationship holds true in this case. So they form a Pythagorean triplet. So the moment we say that 5, 12 and 13, they form a Pythagorean triplet, what we mean is that these three can form the sides of a right angled triangle where the hypotenuse is 13 and one of the sides like the base is 12 and the perpendicular is 5. So they can form a right angled triangle of this fashion. One member of the Pythagorean triplet is given to you and you are asked to find the remaining two members of the Pythagorean triplet. So how will you do that? So this can be a tedious task. Like it is something like this. I just give you a number 5. So I give you 5 and then I say that make a Pythagorean triplet such that 5 is one of the members of the triplet. So how will you find the Pythagorean triplet? So this time you do not know both the other two numbers. So how would you find it out? Okay, so what I am going to do right now is I'm going to give you a very simple trick that will help you to find out the members of Pythagorean triplet. Now, there are two different tricks for odd and even numbers respectively. So our trick number one is for a given odd number, like 5. 5 is an odd number, right? So for 5, we will apply this trick one. So what we do in trick one, so it is a simple three-step trick. So these are the three steps of the trick. Step one, find the square of the given number. So in step one, you find the square of the given number, that is 5 square. So 5 square would be 25. Step number two, divide it by 2. So in step number two, you divide 25 by 2. So how much do you get? You get 12.5. Step number three, the whole numbers between which it lies are the members of the triplet. So 12.5, this is a decimal number, but 12.5 lies between two whole numbers. What are those whole numbers between which 12.5 lies? So 12 and 13. So between 12 and 13 lies 12.5. So 12 is a whole number, 13 is also a whole number. So 12 and 13 are the other members of the triplet. So your final triplet is 5, 12, 13. So that's simple. Yes, the trick is that simple. So you just need to remember these three steps. What? You are given an odd number. Let's take one more example. I think that will be better. So in this time, let's say that you are given a number 19 and you have to make a Pythagorean triplet. So 19 is an odd number. Perfect. So let's follow the steps. Step number one, we will square the number, that is 19 square. So 19 square is 361. Step number two, divide it by 2. So 361 divided by 2, which is equal to 180.5. Step number 3, what are the whole numbers between which 180.5 is located? It is located between 180 and 181. So therefore, 19, 180, 181 forms the Pythagorean triplet. So 180 and 181 are the other two members of the Pythagorean triplet. Now, how do you verify that whatever we have done with this trick is giving the right results? So for verification, what we can do is, let's see if these three numbers satisfy the relationship of Pythagorean triplet. So for that, what we will do, we will find out 19 square, add it to 180 square. So this comes out to be 3240 plus 361, which is equal to 32761. And now we will find out 181 square, which is equal to 32761. So we see that 181 square is equal to 19 square plus 180 square, which proves that they are a Pythagorean triplet. Now, another important thing to note here is, with this trick, you will always be able to find out a Pythagorean triplet for a given odd number. But every time, the given odd number would be the smallest member of the triplet. For example, in the first case, 5 was the given number. So if you look at the triplet, 5 is the smallest member of the triplet. Similarly, in this case, 19 was the given number, and if you look at them, all the three members, you see that 19 is the smallest member of the triplet. So with this trick, every time whatever triplet you find out, the given number would always be the smallest member of the triplet. Another important thing to note here is that with this trick, you will always be able to find a Pythagorean triplet for a given number, but that does not mean that that is the only triplet that you can get from that number. For example, here 5, 12, 13 is a triplet, but that doesn't mean that this is the only triplet where each of these numbers are participating. For example, 12 can be a part of another Pythagorean triplet also, where maybe 12 is the smallest number, right? So there could be multiple triplets involving the same number. That is possible. And it is not possible that all the possible triplets can be verified using this trick, because this is just a trick which we have obtained by back calculation of the Pythagoras theorem formulae. Okay, so let's look at trick number two, which is going to be for an even number. So this is also a three-step trick, but this time the steps are slightly different. So let's take an example of an even number. So let's say we consider 6. So let's say 6 is the given number and we have to find out the remaining two members of the triplet. So step number 1 is divide the given number by 2. So this time you do not square, you first divide. So you divide 6 by 2, so how much do you get? You get 3. Second step, find its square. So now you square 3. So 3 square is 9. The third step, the whole numbers between which it lies are the members of the triplet. So this time 9 itself is a whole number, but we are not interested in 9. We are interested in the numbers which are located before and after 9. So 9 is located between 8 and 10. So that means 6, 8 and 10. These three form a Pythagorean triplet. So if you want, again, this case also you can verify it just by checking whether 6 square plus 8 square is equal to 10 square or not. And you would see that it holds true. So that way 6, 8 and 10 form a Pythagorean triplet. Let's take another example. Let's say you are given a number 22 and you have to find out the remaining two members. Step number 1, divide 22 by 2, which gives you 11. Step number 2, square 11, that is 121. Step number 3, 121 is located between which two numbers? 120 and 122. Therefore, 22, 120 and 122, this forms a Pythagorean triplet. So in this fashion, you need to remember trick 1 and 2 for odd and even numbers respectively. But please do remember that the given number in these tricks will always be the smallest member of the triplet, and there exists many other triplets with the same number, and all triplets cannot be covered by this trick. So this trick applies, this trick is helpful only when one number is given to you and you have to complete the triplet with that number. So in that case, this trick will work.